To all those people watching, I like to remind everyone that this video is not made for kids. It's for older fans and adults. Enjoy the fucking video! Flora is a tram engine that works at the Railway Museum at Vicarstown, giving people rides from the yards to the station. Many years ago, Flora used to work on the old Sodor tramway that was situated at Vicarstown, taking passengers around the area. But when more and more people began travelling by car, bus and lorry, the tramway was closed down, and Flora was withdrawn from service. Thankfully, the museum saved her, but Flora has held on to a deep resentment towards any vehicle that runs on roads. One morning, the track at Vicarstown was being worked on, so people who were heading to the museum had to take the car or travel by bus. Bertie the bus was taking a group of visitors who had come to see the island of Sodor. Today, they were also heading to the Railway Museum. The drive to Vicarstown was long and they were in need of some petrol along the way.
"We'll stop here for a minute to refill Bertie," said his driver to the visitors.
But the visitors were getting agitated.
"Oh, come on, we've been in this bus for hours.
We're closer to the museum than you think. Look at the queue," they said.
"Oh, driver, please, I'm thirsty."
"Well, I'm sure there'll be a petrol station at Vicarstown too, Bertie. I think we can manage a few more miles."
Bertie sighed and he rolled away.
At the Railway Museum, the manager came to see the engines.
"We got some special visitors here today."
"Oh, don't we have them every day?" yawned Caden.
"As I said, we have some special visitors today.
They come from the Railway Society on the mainland, and they'll be seeing you."
Flora was pleased.
"Ooh, visitors from the Railway Society, how exciting!" she said. "When is their train due?"
"Well, Flora, they won't be coming by train today."
"What? Then how else are they going to get here, sir?"
"They'll be coming on Bertie the bus. Our regular visitors will be coming by car and other buses as well today, since track work is being done near the station."
Flora was shocked.
"Cars? Buses?" she fumed.
Jim was worried.
"Easy, Flora," he soothed. "I know what it's like holding a grudge,
but you should be letting it go. It's not good for you.
I can be angry as much as I want to be, Jim. Rural vehicles. They disgust me.
Now, Flora, I understand why you're upset, but you can't have that attitude with our visitors. You need to work on that before they get here.
Soon, Bertie arrives, still feeling thirsty.
He stopped at the car park and the passengers were let off. Then his driver got out to stretch his legs.
Well, we'll be able to get to a petrol station soon, driver.
We will. I just need to give my legs a good stretch and a break from driving.
Okay, sir, replied Bertie, and he yawned. Well, a good snooze might be good for me after this long drive.
Bertie shut his eyes. More visitors came by car, and more buses arrived to drop off their passengers. Meanwhile, Flora looked on, seething with rage.
Cars, buses, lorries, what is the world coming to? Why couldn't they come on a train?
You heard what the manager said, Flora. Trackwork.
I know that, but we could have trains coming down here to drop off the passengers.
But we haven't got a platform suitable for passenger trains, Flora, replied Neil. You just have to put up with it.
Flora just snarled. With the line at Vicarstown being worked upon, Flora's job for the day was to take the passengers up and down the museum yard. But Flora had an idea.
Passengers who haven't been in any rural vehicles are allowed in, she declared.
The passengers, as well as members of the Railway Society, were shocked.
But we came by car, said one.
Oh well, sighed Flora. No ride for you today.
This isn't fair, replied another. We come all the way from Titmouth to see the museum and ride on you, and you're telling us we can't because we came by road?
Exactly, replied Flora slyly. Guess I can't travel for you today.
The passengers, along with the Railway Society members, were very annoyed, and they began to speak to the manager. Meanwhile, Bertie's driver returned from the car park. Bertie saw the commotion and was wondering what was happening.
Oh, this tram engine in Flora has a problem with rural vehicles.
A problem with rural vehicles? That's just sad. What has she got against me?
Search me. Well, let's try and get you filled up.
This made Bertie smile. But as the driver went over the crossing, there was a problem. Bertie was slowing down, and then he stopped. The driver tried turning on his engine again, but nothing happened. Then he saw the fuel light on, and the fuel gauge had empty.
Oh, bother, he said. You're out of petrol.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Bertie. I should have filled you up from where we were previously. Oh, it's all right, driver. But next time, try not to cave in.
Bertie's driver smiled, and then he went off to tell the manager about Bertie. Meanwhile, Flora saw him, and she began to smirk.
Actually, I'm sorry for being so rude. Please hop on board and have a pleasant ride.
The passengers were delighted, but they didn't know about what had happened to Bertie. Once they were on board, Flora puffed away. Just then, Bertie's driver came towards the manager and told him about Bertie.
Okay, where is he? We could try to move him off the tracks.
Bertie's driver was about to show him where Bertie was, but then to his horror, he saw that Flora was heading straight for him. Bertie saw her too and he was shocked.
Stop! Stop! He yelled.
But Flora just smirked, knowing what was coming next.
Her driver saw him up ahead, and she applied the brakes.
This is for all the pain your car has caused me! She shouted. Bertie shut his eyes, waiting for the impact.
But then she stopped, only bumping into him lightly.
Bertie was relieved, but Flora was upset.
Why did you stop me?
She complained to her driver.
Why? We're about to crash into Bertie, that's why, replied our driver crossly. And you knew you were going to crash into me, added Bertie crossly. Just what is your problem with me and roll vehicles in general?
You've ruined my life.
I was once the means for so many people to travel around the Vicarstown area. After my time at Birmingham was ended, once I was replaced by electric trams. Then, when you lot came, people began to take you around the area, and I was left with no passengers at all to the point where the Sodor Tramway Company closed down, and I had to be saved by the good grace of the museum. That's why!
Well, that was really stupid of you, Flora, replied the manager crossly. Not only have you put yourself and Bertie in danger of damage, but you endangered the safety of our passengers. This is absolutely disgraceful coming from you. I will not tolerate this behavior at all. Go to your shed, and you can stay there for the rest of the day and think about what you have done.
So, Flora did.
Topham, who was previously known as Replica Glynn, took over her trains for the rest of the day.
Flora stayed in the shed, brooding to herself. Jim, the narrow gauge engine, saw the whole thing, and he understood what Flora had gone through. He puffed up towards her. Hello, Flora.
Oh, hello, Jim, sighed Flora sadly. I know why you're in your shed. You were about to crash into Bertie on purpose.
I know, replied Flora crossly. It's just that I was so cross after what had happened to me when his kind took away all of my passages, and I wanted to get my revenge.
I understand what it's like for someone to come in and take away something that was once yours. That happened to me with the Northwestern Railway. I called the standard gauge engines monsters, thinking that they had taken our passengers away and caused our line to close down. But I was wrong. After I had my accident at Croven's Gate, Edward saved me, and I began to rethink my words about them. I shouldn't have held the grudge for so long since they were so kind, and it wasn't their fault that my line was closed. The world was changing then, and with that, ideas and behaviors change as well. It's the same with road vehicles, and while I understand your resentment, Flora, they do help us all out as well. And Jim puffed away. Later, the manager came to see Flora.
Please, sir, I'm sorry for being rude today.
And you should be, replied the manager. It's good to see that you are sorry, Flora, but your actions today had given us a bad reputation with our visitors, as well as the Railway Society.
I know, sir, and once again I am truly sorry, sir. I won't ever do something stupid like that again, sir.
That's a good engine. However, I want you to see how useful road vehicles can be to the railway. I'm sending you to Kelsthorpe Road. They have a bus stop close to the station, and you can see it from the yards there. Consider this a learning experience for you.
Yes, sir, replied Flora.
So, Alice coupled up to her, and she was taken to Kelsthorpe Road.
There she saw cars and buses coming and going with passengers who needed to go to and from the station. Then Bertie came by with the Railway Society. They were not pleased to see her after what had happened. Flora apologized to Bertie and the members sincerely and promised that it would never happen again. Bertie and the society members were pleased and hoped she would deliver on her promise next time they saw her. Flora now understood Jim's words, and she could see the usefulness that road vehicles bring to the railways.